Let's go to YouTube. It's your boy, Blue Blood Sports TV, back at y'all with another one. So, Mikey Garcia says that the people gonna learn and they gonna respect him after March 16th. He said everybody doubted him versus Zlatishian. He says that everybody doubted him versus Adrian Broner. Said Adrian Broner was too big, too fast, too strong. He said that everybody doubted him and said that he was avoiding a fight with Robbie Easter, and that's why he fought Sergey Lipinets in fights instead of fighting Robbie Easter. He stated that I took care of all of those fighters. I took care of Adrian Broner, I took care of Robbie Easter, and I took care of Johan Zlatishian. He stated that, why don't you ask Adrian Broner? He says people said Adrian Broner was trash. Adrian Broner didn't come to fight. Adrian Broner wasn't prepared. He said, how about I didn't let Adrian Broner be prepared? I didn't let him get off and be who he's supposed to be. He said, how about, he said, people said that Robbie Easter was overrated. He said, how about he wasn't overrated? I just made him look like he was overrated. He said that people thought that Johan Zlatishian was a knockout artist and he was going to knock me out, and I was crazy for taking that fight. He said, but I knocked him out in the third round. He said, so everybody compares these fighters. I'm always the underdog. Nobody gives me my respect because I don't have a lot of flash and glamour. He says, but people after March 16th, he said Errol Spence will be the next victim. I took care of him, and now I'm going to take care of Errol Spence. He says that is nothing different in this situation than it is with those past situations, which I totally disagree. Errol Spence is not Johan Zlatishian. Errol Spence is not Adrian Broner, who we knew had flaws. Errol Spence is not Robert Easter Jr., who we saw have trouble with Cormier. So, all of these fighters that he named were flawed. I mean, we haven't seen Johan Zlatishian in no mega fights. And Adrian Broner had already previous loss. We saw him knocked down by Marcus Maidana. We saw him look pedestrian versus fighters like Taylor, Emmanuel Taylor. We saw him look pedestrian against guys like Jesse Vargas, just not letting his hands go. Fighters he was way more gifted than, but he just don't show up, just don't let his hands go, right? Not to mention, we saw him look pedestrian versus Sean Porter. Who Sean Porter makes everybody look, could look, make everybody look pedestrian and make it an ugly fight. But Adrian Broner just didn't show up. So all of these fighters were flawed. We can't say the same about Errol Spence. It's not the same thing when you're dealing with Errol Spence. It's just not. You can't compare Errol Spence to any of these fighters. We saw Robbie Easter struggle with multiple fighters. We saw Robbie Easter struggle with at least his last 2 to 3 fights he struggled in, right? Some people even argued that he lost his last fight. Not to mention his last fight before going in a fight with Mikey Garcia. Johan Zlatishian is relatively unknown. Yeah, he had knockouts, but who did he knock out? You know, Mikey Garcia is a great fighter. You know, he's achieved a lot. He's a 4-division champion. But, you know, when you're talking about Errol Spence, it's a whole different beast. So you have to understand why people feel like you're the underdog in this fight. Why people feel like Errol Spence is the superior fighter. Because he's bigger, stronger, faster, literally. You know, people felt like Adrian Broner was bigger, stronger, faster. But it's all about if Adrian Broner was going to let his hands go and let those skill sets show up in the fight. And he just chooses not to. You're not the only fighter he didn't choose to let those things show up in. You know, he didn't let those traits show up in the fight with Emmanuel Taylor. He should have been able to blow out Ashley Theophine easier than he did. You know, you understand? So there's valid reasons for the things that people say in the media and they come out and say. The criticism they have with these fighters. With that said, would you, Errol Spence Jr. is a totally different beast. Totally different beast. We've seen him handle big welterweights like Kell Brook. We've seen him handle tough, rugged fighters like Lamont Peterson with ease. You know, so you coming up 2 weight classes, 1 weight class. Y'all know what I always say. He just admitted that he fought 3 of his last 5 fights at 140 pounds. So, 2 back-to-back at 140 pounds. That makes you a 140-pound fighter campaigning at 135, right? So with that said, people going to say move up 2 weight classes. I say 1, but whichever you choose, right? Whatever floats your boat. 2 weight classes. But, you know, you at a disadvantage. That's the reason that people state this. And 9 times out of 10, a great big man beats a great little man. Adrian Broner wasn't that much of a bigger man than Mikey Garcia. He campaigns at 140 pounds. He went up to 147 pounds for a few fights. The rest of his fights were at catchweight to 144, Sean Porter, and under and below. So it wasn't that much of a difference. This is why I say Errol Spence deserved all the credit in the world should he be victorious, because nobody's making up excuses for Mikey Garcia. They're acting like Mikey Garcia is being disrespected going into this fight. So if Mikey Garcia is being disrespected going into this fight, then Errol Spence needs to get all the credit in the world if he beats Mikey Garcia. If he beats Mikey Garcia with ease and knocks Mikey Garcia out early, there should be no excuses. There should be no reports stating that Errol Spence did what he should have did. No, it should be none of that. Errol Spence he beat another great fighter, point blank and period. No disadvantages. That's just how it should be looked at. There should be no asterisk next to it. There should be no, oh, well, he came up two weight class. None of that. None of that talk should exist when the way Mikey Garcia is talking and the way the rest of the media is talking, as if Mikey Garcia is being disrespected in this fight, point blank and period. But that's all I got for y'all. It's your boy Blue Blood Sports TV. Hate, like, comment, subscribe. You haven't subscribed? Hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, hit the bell icon to get all the new notifications. Follow me on Instagram at Blue Blood Sports TV, all one word. Y'all already know what it is. Shout out to the entire LDBC. Shout out to New Media. Shout out to Black Media, bro. Make sure you like and share these videos. Mikey Garcia says, I handle Adrian Broner and Robert Easter. Now I'm going to handle Errol Spence Jr. That's all I got for y'all. Peace.